The woman at the centre of Victoria's deadly mushroom case has broken her silence to claim she too ate the meal responsible for the deaths of three people. Erin Patterson says she also fell ill and was hospitalised. She also claims to have bought the mushrooms from a major supermarket and a grocery store.
She refused to answer questions.
What took place at the meal? Erin?
We need to leave.
But Erin Patterson has now gone public to put her side, saying she did eat the beef Wellington meal that proved fatal for three people. The 48-year-old says she was also hospitalised, but that doctors gave her a liver-protective drug to help. She also admitted lying to detectives when she initially told them she dumped her food dehydrator at the tip a long time ago. She's since confessed to doing so after the meal was served. While in hospital, Ms. Patterson said she discussed the dehydrator with her children when her ex-husband asked, "Is that what you use to poison them?" Patterson claimed she used a combination of supermarket button mushrooms and dried mushrooms from an Asian grocer, preserving some of the meal to give to hospital toxicologists. When police came knocking, she was advised to give a no-comment interview to police. But now, "I now very much regret not answering some questions following this advice given the nightmare that this process has become." Ms. Patterson's in-laws, Don and Gail Patterson, died after eating lunch at her Leongatha home on July 29. Gail Patterson's sister, Heather Wilkinson, also died. Heather's husband, Ian Wilkinson, remains in a critical but stable condition. The pastor now in desperate need of a liver transplant. Last year, Ms. Patterson's ex-husband, Simon Patterson, was also hospitalised for a mystery stomach illness. With unconfirmed reports, he was poisoned too.
And Cassie Zervos has the latest on the investigation. Cassie, that statement was also given to police.
It was, Mitch, but 7 News understands relatives of the victims are now concerned that the statement released has several inconsistencies to what they know. Although Erin Patterson says she now regrets giving a no-comment interview to police, she hasn't undergone a second interview with homicide investigators, instead relying on that written statement passed on through her lawyers. Mitch.
Cassie Zervos at Police Headquarters, thank you.